USA Tournament Preview Show with sports director Travis Lee on Channel 8 WMTW.
All right, let's take a look at some of our boys' plays of the year. South Portland's Jalen Jackson, the sweep behind the back pass to Hunter Owen for the lay-in. More from the Red Rights, Pamba Pamba to Jeremy Baez for the alley-oop, bag it up. Levitt's Wyatt Hathaway with the wild finish, body control, how's it go? And then the one we've all seen, Storm Gibson of Edward Little, end of the quarter, out of bounds, count it. And Dylan DeRoche, not to be outdone, of Mountain Valley, a three-quarter court shot. Our plays of the year on the boys' side. All right, welcome back to the Hoops 8 show. We're turning to the Class C girls. Boothbay ended Monmouth's run of two straight state championships last year, and they enter the Southern Tournament as the number two seed.
Old Orchard closed the season winning 5 of 6, and Shaney Plant is a high-end 4 general. Audrey Fletcher and Libby Clement lead a Monmouth team that can get after you on defense. They have a win over Boothbay on their resume. St. Dom's features strong guard play, and Becca Zimmerman is having one of the best seasons in the region. After cruising out of the gate, NYA lost 2 of its last 5, but Katie Larson helps make the Panthers one of the top 3-point shooting teams in the region. Winthrop likes to get up and down the floor, and Aaliyah Wilson-Falcone was the MVC Player of the Year. Along with Jillian Smeltzer, Natalie Frost, and Kenna Souza, the Ramblers have 4 players with 4 years of varsity experience. Boothbay closed the season on an 11-game win streak. Chloe Arsenal can take over a game from the point position, and Glory Bleffin is an emerging star.
All right, Michael, Winthrop, they are an incredible story as the number one seed in the CSouth tournament.
Yeah, you said it, Travis. You know, when this year's senior class was in 7th grade 5 years ago, Winthrop had to drop down and become a JV program for a short time. And now here they are back as the number one seed in the region. Joe Burnham's done a phenomenal job coaching that group. And, you know, Boothbay was the team last year. They're still very good, maybe not quite as strong. But this year, Winthrop getting a steal in the headlines, and it's very deserving.
Seed though.
And you know, they've had a great couple of years. Let's not forget, NYA was in the regional final a year ago. And like you said, they came out guns a-blazing to start the season. They've cooled off a little bit lately, but if they're shooting well, look out. And they have confidence knowing they can go up to Augusta and win. They won a couple games up there last year. So I think if you're looking at a team that's maybe not on the 1 or the 2 line that might make a run, maybe it's the Panthers.
And then if you go further down the bracket, number 11 Trape actually beat NYA a couple weeks ago. So they're a team to look out for as maybe an upset. Boothbay and Winthrop, should they meet in a regional championship, contrast in styles. Winthrop loves to run. Boothbay can grind you down, and should be a great tournament. St. Dom's had an excellent season at 14-4. Old Orchard had Maggie Strom coming back. She's been out all year, and they've done a nice job as a contender there as well. All right, thank you, Michael. We're going to turn to the Class C boys now, and Dominic Campbell says playing college basketball was always a dream of his, but now it's a reality. The Wayne Fleet Jr. is getting Division I offers, and the key to his rise up the recruiting ranks, not how he fills it up, but how he fills himself up.
All it takes is a now-and-then look at Dominic Campbell to see the work the 16-year-old has put into being healthier.
I got on the scale, and I saw that I was 297 pounds. I was like, geez, that's a lot. And I really didn't want to hit that 300 mark, so I just decided to look up some ways to get healthier. And one of the biggest things I did was just stop eating at night.
Campbell's 40 pounds lighter today, and his investment in a workout plan and training are paying off.
Biggest thing is getting him stronger, and he's really gotten a lot leaner with that, and obviously from an aesthetic standpoint you can really see the difference. Hopefully then we'll see the difference too with his power output on the court.
Campbell's off the court work has helped translate into a major improvement between the lines.
He's worked on his shooting touch so that he's a threat out to the 3-point line, and as he's gotten more fit, he's been able to play longer and stay out of foul trouble and avoid some of those fatigue fouls that you find. So, you know, he's an all-around player.
I saw this video of a guy because I was trying to learn how to dunk better, and he said, fat don't fly. So that was one of the biggest things, and now I'm dunking pretty easily, so.
Campbell certainly a factor in this tournament. Now, Wayne Fleet expected to contend for the regional title, but the road to the state title has run through Winthrop for the past 4 years.
Mount Abram won't be an easy matchup for anyone. They come in waves, and Nate Luce can play. NYA is a tough matchup inside as T'Andre King controls the paint, and Chris Hamblitz is as athletic a guard as anyone in the region. Hunter Crocker is a game changer at point guard for Boothbay, and the Seahawks have the balance to play with anyone. Wayne Fleet is well tested after a tough regular season schedule. Greg Dahia had a monster season, and few in the region can match up with Dominic Campbell inside. Winthrop's the defending state champ. They do just about everything well. Ryan Baird has elevated his game, and Cam Hashey helps space the defense from outside. On any given night, a different Rambler can lead the team in scoring, and big game experience is on Winthrop's side.
Well, the forecaster's Michael Hoffer rejoins us now. Winthrop has reached at least the regional championship game in the past 4 years. They're a tough out, Mike.
Yeah, and you know, like you said, that big game experience is so invaluable. They're not going to get rattled. They're going to have great support up there, and they're going to be really tough to beat. But I think if there's a team out there that can dethrone them and beat them, it's Wayne Fleet. And they have played so well this season. They've played a lot of games against Class B teams, and they lost one time at Cape Elizabeth. There's no shame in that. You mentioned how good Dominic Campbell is, how fit he is now, and he's just a matchup nightmare. He will rip the heart out of the other team. I saw him steal the ball going for a dunk early in a game earlier this year, and the game was essentially over right there. No one wants to match up with him. Drake Dahia, as you mentioned, has been knocking it down big time from threes, but they have 6, 7, 8, 10 players who can come in and contribute. Rich Henry has his team deep in the tournament every single year, and the one thing Wayne Fleet's missing is that gold ball. They've been to the state game a couple times. They even went to overtime once. This might be the year they take that final step.
Yeah, and they've had some great scorers in this region, too. Ryan Crockett from Old Orchard Beach. NYA has got a great duo with Hamlin and King. Boothbay size and guards, that's a great combo, and no one wants to play Mount Abram. They almost beat Winthrop, and a lot of people will tell you that they maybe should have won that game. And up north, you got Dexter, 18-0, a number two seed up north. So interesting stuff there as the Class C tournament, one of the better ones, unfolds this year. Hey, let's take a look at some of the plays of the year on the girls' side. How about Freeport's Katrina Gould, buzzer beater, and the foul at Yarmouth. Hamden's Amelia McLaughlin from half court, you kidding me, sinks it. Then Cecilia Dietrich of Oxford Hills. This is what she does, beating the buzzer, the one-handed runner from 15. Kent Hills' Naomi McGadney, a falling out of bounds three. This would send this game to double overtime. Some great stuff, our girls' plays of the year. More tournament preview show when we come back.